I welcome you to the Big Fat Mixed Media Tribe, and in today's episode we are going to create an art journal page. I will quickly explain what I'm doing here, and then I will go into the reason of why I made this page and why it looks the way it does. So I'm starting with a very, very ordinary material, which is a packaging paper. If you ever ordered something from Amazon, you know that the boxes arrived stuffed with huge amounts of packaging paper, and it's a very good quality paper, quite thick, and it seemed a shame to me to throw it away, so I'm trying to use it to make albums, and also I'm going to use it today to create a background for my page. I'm going for a vintagey feel, so this brownish paper will be perfect and I don't need to use color or inks to achieve the vintagey feel for my background. So I'm just gluing randomly torn pieces of paper to my journal page, and I'm using a liquid gel medium. Subject of my page is circus, so it is a jolly fun theme, but there will be a twist at the end, and I feel that I need to explain how I came to creating this page. So I was watching a comedian performing, and the person performing happened to be fat, so they were making a lot of fat jokes, and it is quite fashionable among the fat creators to make self-depriving fat jokes because they get laughs. People tend to laugh easily when person on the stage is making self-depriving jokes, and it made me think about, you know, the posters you have seen about the freak shows in Victorian times and even later, with people of different body types being shown for entertainment and for laughs. Tall people, small people, fat people, ill people. It was all a freak show to get easy laughs. And whenever I see images from those performances, I get sad, I get angry, and I'm not sure if I'm explaining this right, but I'm trying to explain the reasoning behind the sad journal page. It hurts people. When you laugh at somebody, it hurts people, and luckily we have moved on from the freak shows, but still we are very, very long way away from accepting all types of bodies as normal. So let's return back to the techniques I'm using. So I was using stencils to create different patterns on my background. Whenever possible, I was using permanent inks just to make it easier for me to go over with the next layers. And I chose a diamond pattern and this starburst pattern, which reminded me of circus, jolly, funny circus posters. And then I went through my stash and got out all kinds of circus-related ephemera. So I'm using pictures of animals, some pictures of clowns, and also some pattern papers, which went well with the color scheme. And I'm gluing them down, this time using heavy gel medium so that it doesn't soak too much into the papers. I'm not planning specifically where I will glue what. I'm just taking little pieces of papers. Here you see some vintage tickets which I tore with my hands to not have a very precise edge. Again, pattern paper, some elephant, I like this elephant a lot, and I'm going around the edge of my page to sort of create a frame. Although this is a circus themed page, I'm not trying to recreate a circus scene. I'm just trying to use elements that remind of circus to get a feeling, to convey a feeling of circus. Now that all the little ephemera pieces are glued down, let's move to the next layer. We will come back to the little stickers that I glued down, but first we need to add one more layer. So I'm adding a structure paste, or this is Tonic Studio's paste, which is supposed to expand when you heat it, but it's quite old. I've had it for 2 years now and it's very dry, so I was pleasantly surprised that I'm still able to use it through the stencil. It did take some effort, but I was able to use it. And I would have extended it or make it more liquid, like I usually do with structure paste, but I'm not sure if you can do it with the expanding paste. So if you have tried it, let me know if there is something I can do. Turn to these little stickers. Since they were stickers, I had this white border around them. So I'm going to put a layer of color on top of them. That is why before that I'm using an ink pencil to create shadows around each and every element. Normally, as you know, I would use my beloved charcoal pencil, but since there will be one more layer on top and I don't want them shadows to move, and charcoal would move if I would do something on top, I'm using a very, very dark gray ink pencil. And then a brush dipped in water to dilute the pencil mark and make it look like a shadow. And now just to unify the page and not have the stickers be so obvious, I'm going over them with brown ink, and this is part of my attempt to avoid using acrylic paints lately, because I cannot solve the problem of them getting darker and the page after a while starting to look much darker than the moment that I created it. So that's why I'm using brown ink, and as you can see, the images, little images, are disappearing in the background, and the white borders are disappearing, and the page looks more unified. And it will also allow me to add the focal element, which I know is not very bright, and the focal element will stand out better. And just for some added interest, I'm adding white and black splashes. So, this will be, I thought, since this is a circus, I need something like a curtain or a drapery. I thought that I will use this dye to create some decorative elements on top of my page. Again, I didn't want to create curtain as such. I didn't want to be too precise and too obvious about this being a circus scene. So I die cut this decorative element, cut it in half, and glued it on the top part of my page. And while it's drying, I'm going to create the top layer for this decorative element, and I'm using a red cardstock this time, cutting the same decorative element, and I want to emboss it. And normally, if I need to emboss a big piece like that, I would use a gel medium to adhere the embossing powder. But this time I'm using a very ordinary household item, which is glycerin. And glycerin is sticky, so it will stick both to the papers and to the embossing powder. Okay, the embossing powder will stick to the glycerin. And I'm not very precise about applying it, because I want the red cardstock to shine through, to be visible through, to have a little bit more grungy effect. And the good thing about using glycerin instead of gel medium is I have noticed that gel medium tends to dry very flat. So the embossing powder dries very flat. But with glycerin, it still has a little bit this 3D effect, so I'm quite happy with how it looks now. And it needs to be glued down, so I'm cutting it in half. And then I thought that I will do something. I thought for about it for a moment because I was not sure how it will turn out. And I decided to scrunch it. Ooh, it was scary. I was afraid that the powder will fall off, the embossing will fall off. But it didn't. So and I ended up with this really distressed metallic looking decoration for my page. Very happy about how it looks. I'm gluing it down again. I'm using art glitter glue today to glue everything. So there will be the black elements visible and now the red element on top. And I think that it has brought the page together. It has helped to frame the page. And also added this luscious, if I may say, feeling of circus performance. Now I need my text, and for that I will be using this huge die. And I'm cutting out letters, and I cut each letter 3 times. When you use this big die, it's very good. You can run 3 layers of cardstock through and get 3 letters cut with one passing through the die cutting machine. And this will be my text, just for laughs, because circus is for laughs, circus is for fun, of course. So we do all this supposedly just for laughs. I will glue the letters down and then it will be time for the focal point. And this is my focal point. It is a vintage photo of a lady called Jolly Trixie. I'm not sure if it's her real name. It was really difficult to find more about her on internet. You can find her measurements, even you can find her weight, but you cannot find anything more about her as a person. And this is just adds to the thought that people who look differently become freak show. They get robbed of their humanity. And that's why I chose this image. I'm gluing it down. She looks happy in this picture. She's holding a flower. She's looking at the flower. But I will add one more element to this page, to her image. And I had this in my head since the moment that I thought about this page. With this, I'm expressing my sadness and my anger at people becoming targets, and I'm drawing this where her heart is to represent the hurt, that she is target of hurt. Yes, I drew it and then I thought for quite a bit, should I leave the target there or not? Will it be understood or not? But altogether, I really like how this page looks, and it was very personal to me, very emotional page to make, and I hope you enjoyed watching it. Here are some still images from the finished art journal page, and I see you soon in the next episode.